So you think you're pretty smart, eh? I did go to Oxford University once for a conference. Well, let's find out. There are three numbers on the screen, the relationship between which is governed by a simple rule. Your task is to figure out that rule and then generate three of your own numbers that you could use to test whether your interpretation of the rule is correct. Did you guess that the rule governing this string of numbers was that each number in the series had to be even and larger than the preceding number? Perhaps you used this information to generate number strings of your own, such as 12, 14, and 16.
I knew I'd get it right.
If so, then I'm afraid you've failed this little test.
Wait, what?
And in doing so, have demonstrated a very common cognitive bias that undermines your thinking and reasoning. Stay tuned to find out more about this bias and what you can do to avoid it in the future. In 1960, Peter Wason discovered that when presented with the test that you've just done, most people would respond by saying that the rule governing the numbers was that they had to be ascending and even. Here's the twist. The actual rule governing the number strings was simply that each number had to be larger than the last. It didn't matter if they were odd or even. So, although producing a string of ascending even numbers does fit with the actual rule, it doesn't actually capture it. Of course, the participants didn't realize this because they were too busy generating strings of numbers that only sought to confirm their interpretation of the rule.
Oh well, at least it wasn't just me.
The tendency to gravitate towards things that support our existing beliefs and downplay the significance of things that refute those beliefs is called confirmation bias. If this bias were limited to numerical brain teasers, it probably wouldn't be much of a concern. Unfortunately, decades of subsequent research have shown it to be a fundamental flaw in our thinking and reasoning throughout our everyday lives. So what causes it, and is there anything we can do about it? Well, there are a couple of basic things that likely contribute to our tendency to gravitate towards things that confirm our thinking. The first of which is, well, we like being right. It feels good.
No shit, Sherlock.
So, we have a vested motivational interest in searching for, interpreting, and recalling information in such a way that suggests that this is the case. To aid in this process, we often use different standards of evidence to judge information according to how palatable we find it. We tend to require a lower standard of evidence and look for reasons to accept information that supports our beliefs, readily deeming such information to be reliable and credible. In contrast, when we're presented with information that contradicts our beliefs, we tend to adopt a more critical approach and look for reasons to reject that information, readily dismissing it as unconvincing or unreliable.
Okay, so how do I avoid doing this?
To negate your tendency to want to be right, you have to be proactive in applying one of the key principles of the scientific method, known as falsifiability, to your thinking on any given topic.
What do you mean?
This just means that you need to be able to clearly specify what kind of evidence would be needed to refute your thinking on a particular topic, and then prioritize looking for such evidence. Let's illustrate how this works by applying it to the test that I gave you earlier. When you deduced that the rule governing the number sequence was that each number had to be ascending and even, you could have sought to test or falsify your belief by proposing a number string where each number was ascending and odd. If you did this and found out that your numbers were still compliant with the underlying rule, then you'd know that your original belief that the rule governing the numbers were that they had to be ascending and even was wrong. Another reason that we're vulnerable to confirmation bias is that our thinking and reasoning is not driven by an unwavering quest for the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. We just don't have the time, energy, or information processing capacity for that. Instead, we use our capacity to think and reason in a much more tight-fisted fashion, expending as much effort as the purpose we have in mind and the situation we find ourselves in calls for.
What do you mean exactly?
Think about it. The lion's share of our time is spent either alone or in the company of friends and families whose views are often known to us, in fairly relaxed environments where we don't often have to make massively important decisions. Under these conditions, it makes perfect sense that we're not inclined to be at mental DEFCON 1 all of the time and expend the considerable effort required to continuously critically reflect on our thinking. Also, from a social point of view, no one really wants to be that person at the party.
I don't mind. I just want attention.
Research suggests that we only ever really break out of the easy but often unreliable confirmatory thinking process when we believe we might have to justify our views to people who we think are well-informed, motivated to find out the truth, and whose views are unknown to us. So if you really want to beat confirmation bias, you have to act as if you are, or be proactive in seeking out situations in which you need to justify your views and respond to different viewpoints.
Yeah, but I really don't want to join a debating society.
This doesn't mean you have to join a debating society. It might just mean a chat with a friend or colleague who happens to be knowledgeable about the topic in question. Equally, you might invite someone whose views you know to be different to your own for a civilized chat over a cup of coffee. Looking for evidence that you're right might seem like an intuitively sound way of validating your thinking. But if you really want to prevent confirmation bias getting in the way of you understanding something, then you should be deciding on what evidence would convince you that you're wrong and look for that instead.
Fine, this is gonna be a serious buzzkill though. Although I guess that's the point.
See you in the next video.